15 years, and we are using the measure to the major. This is a common carotid artery, and this is Bob, and this is the ICA. And we using the GE machine to measure the study subject. And we get the average of the IMT and the maximal IMT. And we using this summation and this marker and to correlate with the cardiovascular risk factors and the environmental exposure. So this is showing that the intimal medial thickening is strongly associated with the traditional risk factors, such as the obesity or the blood pressure component and lipid profile and inflammation marker and albuminuria. And the albumin level was negative associated. Other is a very strongly positive association. So this slide is showing that women have a higher exposure, you know, because every woman like to be very good smelling. So in the young people, because the study subject is very young, overweight have a higher exposure. Because even the salad is very quickly metabolized. However, it's more lipid dissolved. And after the adjustment, creating adjusted to because we're using the urine sample, we have to adjust by the creatine levels. And we found that the CMP label is associated with the MEHP and the summation DHP. And here we demonstrate that the MEHP levels in different area, such as the mean and the max level, either in the CCA level, the ICA location, and the bulb, or the IMT mean or IMT maximal. It's the similar picture that dose-dependent pattern. We found the MEHP exposure will increase the subclinical atherosclerosis marker. And this is also, we look at the MMBP. The picture is the similar. And we look at the multiple logistic regression to see the CMT level increase for the higher quartile. And we found that the MMBP will increase the 2.8. Compared to the lower quartile. MEHP is a very high level, so it's seven times of the risk. Summation DHP also increased. So the discussion that urine salicylate metabolite are significant and positively associated with the KLD IMT, including CCA, ICA, and above, and the mean IMT after controlling the associated factors. The major salicylate exposure is the MMBP, MEHP, and the summation DHP. The association in relatively young people and adolescents indicate the evidence is very important and not by chance. So this is another study that from the enhanced study. It's showing that the MMBP and the MBGP that the associated with the type 2 diabetes. And they also showing that the fasting glucose level and the HOMA IR that they increase in the higher level MMBP and the summation DHP. So this is evidence from the enhanced from the United States. And what kind of mechanism? That is just published last year to showing that the in vitro evidence of the MEHP impact on lipolysis, glucose uptake and glycolysis, and the mitochondria respiration and biogenesis demonstrate that the MEHP accumulation disturbs the energy metabolism of fat cell. So the MEHP-treated adipocyte displayed a similar increase in glucose uptake at here. And MEHP treatment during the adipogenesis might alter the normal gene expression pattern and lead to the consequent change in insulin sensitivity. And this is another study that to demonstrate that the DHP exposure and induced MMP2 and MMP9 exposure So at here, we found the DHP at dose of higher than 3.5 ppm, it would induce the cell migration. So this is a conclusion for the DHP exposure. Increase the insulin resistance, increase endothelial microparticle, endothelial dysfunction, and they will increase KLD-AMT. So the risk of cardiovascular health has to be pay more attention. The second part I was talking about the prolactin chemical and the cardiovascular health. So this is because you find that the structure is very strong, you know. It is resistant to the acid and the alkaline. The two most widely known the PFC is octane sulfate, and another is octanic acid, the PFOA. This is an important process of the photolithography process in Taiwan. That's very important for the semiconductor industry. So every day we will expose you to here. So this is a common exposure to our populations. So in Taiwan, the semiconductor company, they're using many PFOS. And however, that is a very long life. It's about 5.4 years in human. And in the natural environment, maybe it's 50 years. So the drinking water and the food and the dust in the home and the migration from the food packaging. This is a study that want to demonstrate that the semiconductor, they waste the water dissolved. And we found the PFOS is very high contaminated in the waste water. From here, it's very high. 5,004 compare other country studies. There is a very high exposure to PFOS, and it is a final inference. It's very high from the photolithography, the factory. And among the exposure, mostly coming from the PFOS. This is the in Taiwan the Hsinchu. The industrial the area, the Kaya River, and here's the one to demonstrate any wastewater treatment plant has any effect.
Zifam, caring for well-being.